गुरुरेव गतिः गुरुमेव भजे गुरुणैव सहास्मि नमो गुरवे न गुरोः परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोर्मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो। राम राम राम। सो टुडे वी शैल कंटिन्यू व्हाट वी हैड लेफ्ट इन द लास्ट क्लास। ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैड फिनिश्ड फ्यू कृदंतास, दैट इज शत्रु प्रत्यय एंड एज वेल एज शानश प्रत्यय। सो टुडे वी विल लुक इनटू न्यू प्रत्यय। सो एनी डाउट्स इन द प्रीवियस क्लास?
No doubt.
ओके, सो नाउ टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट सेट ऑफ प्रत्ययस। सो द प्रत्ययस दैट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग टुडे, एज आई टोल्ड यू, प्रत्ययस कम इन पेयर्स। सो लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस द कृदंतास दैट वर क्षत्र एंड शानश, विच वर अ पेयर दैट वर यूज्ड फॉर प्रेजेंट एंड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट पेयर। सो टुडे द टॉपिक वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग इज तवतु एंड त। सो तवतु एंड त आर वन पेयर दैट आर यूज्ड फॉर पास्ट टेंस। सो वी ऑलरेडी हैव लंगलकार लोटलकार ऑल्सो फॉर पास्ट टेंस, बट दिस इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ यूसेज अगेन wherein these also are used for past tense, but the other important thing is past perfect. So we don't have a separate tense called past perfect in our lakaras. Hence, past perfect, for example, if you want to use passive voice, the fruit was eaten by me. So was eaten is a past perfect form of the verb. Since lakaras don't give you such usages, you can use tavatu and ta pratyaya to get those past perfect forms of different verbs. Again, these are called, so the English name, sorry, the Sanskrit name for Kshatriya and Shanash Pratyas, those type of Pratyas were called Vartamana Kridanta and Bhavishyat Kridanta. Whereas for these, it is called Bhuta Kridanta. As the name itself tells, Bhuta is past. So Bhuta Kridanta, these are used for past tense. They can either be simple past or past perfect. Again, in this particular type of Pratyas, whenever this Tavatu and Ta Pratyas are used, they form declinable forms, like how we saw in Kshatriya and Shanash. So in Kshatriya Pratyaya, you had Pachan, Pachanti, Pachat for Pulinga, Srilinga, Napumsakalinga. Similarly, in this Tavatu and Ta also, you have declinable forms and they vary in Linga, Vibhakti, Vachana. So each word, when you use Tavatu or Ta Pratyaya, will get three Lingas, and each of these Lingas will have seven Vibhaktis, with three Vachanas each. One more important aspect is Tavatu Pratyaya. Always, whenever you use Tavatu Pratyaya on any Dhatu, that always follows a subject. Hence, that is Kartr Pradhana Pradhanam. So whatever the Tavatu Pratyaya form you get, it is always more, it always follows the subject. Hence, it is more used in Kartari Prayoga. Whereas Ta Pratyaya, it follows the object. And since object is of importance in Karmani Prayoga, Ta Pratyaya usages is more seen in Karmani Prayoga rather than Kartari Prayoga. So the main difference between Tavatu and Ta is, Tavatu is used for Kartari Prayoga, Ta is used for Karmani Prayoga. If you see Kshatriya and Shanash, they can be used for any Prayoga. The difference was, Kshatriya was used for Parasmaipadi, Shanash was used for Atmanepadi. So this is the introduction to Tavatu and Ta Pratyaya. Now let us look into each of them. Tavatu Pratyaya, again, it is a simple past tense. So this is, Tavatu is only used for simple past tense. It's not used for past perfect. It's a Bhuta Kridanta. It follows subject as we have discussed. Now we'll see the forms that take up when you use Tavatu Pratyaya. So the rule is the dhatu plus tavatu. The tavatu is the name given to the pratyaya, but what remains after joining is vat. And that vat is what changes the form based on the linga, pullinga, strilinga, and napumsakalinga. For pullinga, that vat will become van. For strilinga, that vat will become vati. Whereas for napumsakalinga, vat will continue to remain vat. And as you can see, the pullinga form resembles takaranta pullinga bhagavan shabda. Bhagavan, Bhagavanto, Bhagavanta, He Bhagavan, He Bhagavanto, He Bhagavanta, Bhagavantam, Bhagavanto, Bhagavata, Bhagavata, Bhagavadhyam, Bhagavadhi, Bhagavate, Bhagavadhyam, Bhagavadhya, and the form continues. The Strilinga form is similar to Ikaranta, Nadi Shabda. And the Napumsakalinga is again, as we had in Kshatriya Pratyaya, Takaranta, Jagat Shabda. Just for your understanding, first we'll look into some examples of how the Dhatus combine, and then again, similar to how I had given in Kshatriya Pratyaya, I will give you the declinable forms of each of those, Pullinga and Napumsakalinga, because Strilinga Nadi Shabda is very easy. So I'll just give you the declinable forms from Shabda Chandrika for Pullinga and Napumsakalinga. So here, for Gam Dhatu, when you add Tavatu Pratyaya, you get Gatavan, Gatavati, Gatavat. Gatavan is for Pullinga, Gatavati is for Strilinga, and Gatavat is for Napumsakalinga. Similarly for Pach, Pachitavan, पचितवती पचितवत, स्थितवान स्थितवती स्थितवत, पठितवान पठितवती पठितवत, दृष्टवान दृष्टवती दृष्टवत, चोरितवान चोरितवती चोरितवत, कृतवान कृतवती कृतवत. सो दीज आर सम कॉमन धातुस दैट यू कम अक्रॉस. सो आई हैव टेकन दीस एंड हैव टोल्ड यू हाउ द तवतु प्रत्यय एक्ट्स ऑन दीस धातुस टू गिव यू द वेरियस पुल्लिंग स्त्रीलिंग नपुंसक लिंग फॉर्म्स. नाउ to give you, to tell you how to decline these shabdas. So once you use tavatu pratyaya on a pullinga, you get these types of usages. So the form that you get will be similar to Bhagavan shabda, as I told you, Bhagavat shabda actually. It takes these 27 forms. So if you have to know all these 27 forms to be able to use them. So how we will use the different vibhaktis, I will tell you in the examples. So this is the pullinga form. Napumsakalinga, this was very similar to kshatri pratyaya. So the first three, that is the prathama, sambodhana prathama, as well as dvitiya, are similar to napumsakalinga jagat shabda. But after that, from the tritiya vibhakti, it will follow marus shabda, takaranta pullinga marus shabda. So this one we had already discussed even in kshatri pratyaya. So this is the forms for pullinga and napumsakalinga. So please learn these shabdas correctly so that you can decline them as per need. So this is again taken from Shabda Chandrika. Now let us see how we can use tavatu pratyaya in our examples. Let us take a very simple example. I read. We are using past tense, so I read. So how will you use it in a lakara, lang lakara? So lang lakara, aham apatham, apata tapatatam apatan, apataha apatatam apatata, apatam apatava apatama. So uttama purusha ekavachana is apatam. Hence I read will become aham apatam. Now let us try to use the same sentence I read, but now using, instead of using lakaras, let us use krizantas. That is, we have understood tavatu pratyaya. Hence we will use tavatu and try to translate the same sentence, I read. So what happens is, again you have to again understand that some krizantas, they only form as a secondary verb. So like how we saw in kshatri and shanish pratyaya, they don't form the main verbs, they only form the secondary verbs. But here tavatu pratyaya can be used as primary verb, so they don't need a lakara based primary verb for its existence. For example, if you want to tell in kshatri pratyaya, aham pathan asmi, pathan is the kridanta, but asmi is the main verb that will add the completeness to the sentence. But that does not have to be the same for tavatu pratyaya. In tavatu pratyaya, the kridanta itself can be the primary noun and the sentence is still complete. For example, in this case, if aham is male, then it will become aham pathitavan, and if it is female, aham pathitavati. So you don't need a second verb to complete the sentence. Okay, any doubts still here in the first two examples?
Yeah, I have one doubt. So yeah, when you translate aham apatam to English, yeah, and aham pathitavan to English, is it the same? For instance, is it apatam is past perfect, right? So is pathitavan also past perfect?
No, apatam is past, just simple past. Lang lakara is simple past.
Okay. But patitavan is perfect past, is it?
No. That is in the ta pratyaya. We are still in tavatu pratyaya. Tavatu is for simple past. Ta pratyaya can be used for simple past as well as past perfect.
Normal lang lakara would be I have read.
No. Lang lakara is I read. Yeah, I have read. I read.
Yeah, I read. Yeah.
I read is the correct way. I have read is the, you know, sometimes when you translate it literally, again, that is the main difference when you do translations. You don't get the exact meaning that you have in Sanskrit in English. So you usually, you know, end up translating aham apatam sometimes as I read, which is the grammatically correct way. And sometimes I have read becomes the translation when, you know, sometimes the sentence does not make sense. So the literal translation for lang is I read, which is simple past tense. Similarly for patitavan also, I read will be the translation. But based on the context, sometimes you may bring in have and make it I have read. Okay, any doubts?
Thank you.
Okay, so now that is the first two sentences where I told how patitavan, that is tavatu pratyaya, can act as the main verb. Now, as I've told you in the very first slide for tavatu and ta, both tavatu and ta can also form declinable forms. So they, whenever you have, what you should understand is, whenever you have a declinable form like a kridanta, it'll always be used as an adjective. Like how we saw in kshatri pratyaya, call the crying girl. So crying is the adjective to the girl, but crying is still a verb in a present continuous form. Hence in Sanskrit that will become kshatri pratyaya. Similarly in these sentences also, in the next few sentences, these tavatu pratyaya will become the adjectives to the main sentence. So again, we use the subclause main clause concept in the previous slides, in the previous prakrantas. We'll use the same concept. So now, the playing boys went. The simple sentence is the boys went. What type of boys went? The playing boys. So here you are using the playing as the adjective. But here, why you have used this is to show you that you can use multiple types of kridantas in the same sentence. Now, playing is what type of tense?
Present continuous.
Very good. So present continuous. So what is the corresponding kridanta that you can use in Sanskrit?
Shatru.
Yeah, so again, if it is Shatru or Shanish, again depends on the Kriyapada. So, play is Creed, and Creed is a Parasmaipadi Dhatu in Sanskrit. So, the only way to use Parasmaipadi Dhatu in present continuous is to use Shatru Pratyaya. If it was a Atmanepadi verb, it would have become Shanish Pratyaya. So, since Creed is a Parasmaipadi Dhatu, Creed and Taha. So, you are using Balaka, which is a Pullinga form, and in that you want to use present continuous, which is Shatru Pratyaya, and in that you have to use Bahuvachana because you're talking about boys. So balaka, so the simple sentence, the boys went. If you use lakaras, it will be balakaha agachan. Agachat agachatam agachan. So the simple sentence in lakara format will be balakaha agachan. But now let us leave the adjective playing aside. Let us now translate this based on kridanta format. So if you use kridanta, again, it should be for pullinga. It should be past tense and it should be bahuvachanam. Hence, balakaha kriditavan. Balakaha kriditavan. Balakaha kriditavantaha. I'm just giving you an example of the boys played. Now, if you use gach dhatu, balakaha agachat, balakaha agachan. Now, if you use kridanta format, balakaha gatavan, balakaha gatavantaha. So, that will be a simple sentence of the boys went. Now, what type of boys went? Playing boys. Since we already had this discussion, playing is a present continuous tense. Hence, the only way to use it is using Shatru Pratyaya. And Shatru Pratyaya should use Pullinga Bahuvachana format. Hence, Kridan, Kridantau, Kridantaha. So, Kridantaha. Since Balaka is the Kridan, the playing is the adjective to Balaka, whatever is the Purushaya Vachana of that and Linga Purushaya Vachana of that word, the adjective also will get the same thing. So, Balaka is Pullinga, Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. Hence, the kridanta format, Shatru Pratyaya of Kreed Dhatu, should also take up Pullinga Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. So, Kreedan, Kreedantau, Kreedantaha. So, Kreedantaha, Balakaha. And again, as we have already discussed, went can either be Agachan in Lakara format or Gatavantaha in Tavatu format. So, Kreedantaha, Balakaha, Gatavantaha. So, this example tells you that in the same sentence, you can have two different types of Pratyayas acting in two different places. One place it is the main verb, which is Gatavantaha. In the other place, it is adjective, which is kridantaha. Okay, so this is the third example. Any doubts in the third example? Okay, so now we will go into the fourth example. The two penancing sages obtained moksha. Now, what is the simple sentence in this?
Sages obtained moksha.
Yeah, the sages obtained. So we leave the two also. We leave the adjective penancing also. We'll just take the sages obtained.
Obtained moksha.
Yeah. So what is sages? Santaha is what I've taken. Okay, we can take Rishi also. So Santa or Rishi, both of them can be the words. So now we will take the Bhuvachana. Let us not take the two into consideration. So sages obtained moksha. So sages will take it as Rishi in this case. So what's the Bhuvachana form?
Rishihi, Rishayaha.
Very good. So, Rishihi, Rishi, Rishayaha. Very good. So, Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachanam will be Rishayaha. So, Rishayaha obtained moksha. Obtained will take it as Aprapnot. So, probably it is a new dhatu for you. Aprapnot is the word. So, if you decline it, since we are using it as a Kartari Prayoga format, so the Kriyapada should follow the subject, not the object. So since we are talking about sages and not one sage, it will also be in Prathama, Prathama Purusha, Bahuvachanam. Aprapnot, Apnuvatam, Aprapnuvatam, Aprapnuvan. So, Rishayaha, Aprapnuvan. What did they obtain? Moksha. So, Moksha is the word. So, as we know in from kartari prayoga usage, the object should be in dvitiya vibhakti ekavachanam. So what will the final translation for this be?
Shayaha moksham
prapnuvantah. Yeah, prapnuvan or
aprapnuvan.
Rishayaha moksham aprapnuvan. Now let us change the vachana only. So we'll take two sages obtained moksha. So how will you change this?
Rishi moksham apatatapatam aprapnuvatam.
Aprapnuvatam.
Very good. So Rishi, Rishi, Rishayaha. So Dvitiya Vibhakti will be Dvivachana will be Rishi. So Rishi Moksham Aprapnuvatam. Now let us again try. So we are still in the Lakara. We are not gone into the Kridanta form. So now we'll change from Lakara to Kridanta. So we have to know that Prap the Dhatu will get Prapnoth. Sorry, Praptavan will be the word. So Praptavan is the Pullinga form. And the Bahuvachana form will be so Bhagavan, Bhagavanto, Bhagavantah. So Praptavan, Praptavanto, Praptavantah. But since we are only talking about two sages, how will it be declared as Praptavanto? So Rishi Moksham Praptavanto. Now we will bring into the bring in the adjective. So what type of rishis obtained moksha? Penancing. So tapad again, this is again penancing. What type of a tense is it?
Present continuous.
Very good. So present continuous tense. So again, you should use kshatriya pratyaya. And what linga should it be in?
Follow rishi.
Sorry.
It should follow rishi, which is the noun.
Very good. So the main noun on which the penancing adjective is adding is rishi. So rishi is pullinga. Hence, kshatriya pratyaya should use the pullinga form. What will be the vachana and the vibhakti?
Dvitiya vibhakti, prathama vibhakti.
Dvitiya vibhakti.
So who is the, what is the noun here?
It's Rishi.
Rishi. So Rishi is which?
Prathama vibhakti. Prathama vibhakti, dvivachana.
Very good. So prathama vibhakti dvivachana is Rishi. Hence, the kshatriya pratyaya should also have pullinga, prathama vibhakti and dvivachana. So tapan, tapanto, tapantaha is the kshatriya pratyaya for tap dhatu. Tap is the dhatu. Tapati, tapataha, tapanti will be the lakara form.
Tapan, tapanto.
Yeah, tapan, tapanto, tapantaha is the kridanta form. And this particular usage requires prathama vibhakti, dvivachanam. So tapantau. So the final sentence will be tapantau, rishi, moksham, praptavantau. Any doubts in the sentence?
Can you use tapantau rishi moksham aprapnuvantam? Can you use that form?
Yes, you can use. That is the lakara form. So if you want to use lakaras, if you're so the main reason why tavatu pratyaya is added this for some sentences, the more common usage is tavatu pratyaya rather than the for example, aprapnuvantam is not a very common type of word that you come across when you read books. Praptavan is the common, you know, usage. So sometimes what happens is some dhatus, they appear, they hear more well when you use pratyas instead of lakaras. That is the only reason why we use kridantas. So as
you I have a question.
Just a minute. So as you told, tapantau rishi moksham aprapnuvatam is correct. But aprapnuvatam is again, though it is the correct lakara usage, sometimes the books usually use praptavan usage, kridanta usage. Hence, this is a alternative.
Praptavan, that is more used in.
Yeah. So praptavan, that's what. Some lakaras, some dhatus take up lakaras more easily and they sound very well. But some dhatus, they take kridantas and they sound very well. So based on that, you say that is more commonly used. It's not like the only way to use or it's not the correct way. I can't tell it's the only correct way to use. It's a more common way to use. Okay. And yeah, please ask the doubt that you had.
Yes, Anna.
Yeah.
Anna, how does it become praptavantau?
So, as I told you, we have to now convert the lakara into kridanta. And again, as I told you, this particular tavatu pratyaya is based on kartari prayoga. So, kartari prayoga is a prayoga wherein the verb follows the subject. So here the subject is Rishi. There's two sages. Hence, Praptavan, so Prapt is the Dhatu. You have to add Tavatu Pratyaya. But as you know, Tavatu Pratyaya is based, is, you know, has different forms for different Linga, Vibhakti and Vachana. Hence, you should always take the Linga, Vibhakti, Vachana based on the subject for Tavatu Pratyaya. In this case, Rishi is Pullinga, it is Prathama Vibhakti and it is Dvivachana. Hence, even for Prabdhatu, the Tavatu Pratyaya should use Pullinga, Prathama Vibhakti, Dvivachana. And if you see this slide, here, Praptavan. So, this is the just general way to decline. So, you have to use different Lakaras, different Dhatus for this particular. So, Prabdhatu, it will be Praptavan, Praptavanto, Praptavantaha, Praptavantam, Praptavanto, Praptavataha, Praptavata, Praptavadhyam, Praptavadhi. So, this declination goes on. But we are interested only in Pullinga, Prathama Vibhakti, Dvivachanam. So, it will be Praptavan, Praptavanto. So, that is how Praptavanto comes there. Is your doubt clarified or do you have some other doubt? Okay, so we can go into the next example.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the final example for this Tavatu Pratyaya is the sleeping child saw a dream. So what is a simple sentence? What is the simple sentence for this, basic sentence for this structure?
The child saw a dream.
Very good. The child saw a dream. So now first we will convert it into Lakara, like the general Sanskrit sentence. So how will you change the child saw a dream? How will you see the, can you give me the translation? So you can use the words in the sentence given.
No, it is Sapnam Drishtavan.
Yeah. No. I want it in the Lakara form first. We'll discuss because since we are all...
Swapnam Apashyat.
Very good. Shishuhu Swapnam
Apashyat.
So why it is Apashyat is, first of all, we are talking about past tense, so it should be Lang Lakara. Secondly, Shishu is neither Madhyama Purusha or Uttama Purusha. So as I've told you, if it's not Aham or if it's not Tvam, then it can only be Tritiya, so that is Prathama Purusha, that is third person. So any particular names, like any proper nouns, any pronouns, everything will come under Prathama Purusha. Hence, Shishu is again a Prathama Purusha word. So, Prapta, Apashyat. So, the Langlakara form for Drish Dhatu is Apashyat, Apashyatam, Apashyan, Apashyaha, Apashyatam, Apashyata, Apashyam, Apashyava, Apashyama. So, for this particular usage, it will be Shishuhu, Swapnam, Apashyat. Now, we will convert. Very good. So now let us come to the Kridanta form. So for Drish Dhatu, if I go back to this thing, Drish Dhatu with Tavatu Pratyaya, it will become Drishtavan, Drishtavati, Drishtavat. So now Shishuhu, though in English the Shishu, the child is neutral, but in Sanskrit Shishu is a Pullinga Pada, hence you should use only Pullinga form. So since there is only one Shishu, so here Shishuhu is Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam form for Pullinga. Hence, Tavatu should also take Pullinga Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachana form, which is Drishtavan. So, Shishuhu Swapnam Drishtavan. Now, what type of a Shishu are we talking about? Sleeping. And as you know, Sheeing or the Dhatu used for sleeping, what type of Padi is it? So, Sheeing is an Atmanepadi form.
Atmanepadi form.
Very good. So, what type of a Kridanta will you use for present continuous? So, as if sleeping is present continuous tense. So, for present continuous tense, for Atmanepadi, which Kridanta will we use?
Shanashpratyaya.
Very good. So, Shanashpratyaya.
Shanashpratyaya.
Very good. So, Shanashpratyaya, it should follow again, as I have told you, the noun. So, sleeping should follow this child, Shishu. Hence, you should, what is Shishu? It is Pullinga Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Hence, even the Kridanta form should also have Pullinga Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachana form, which is Shayanaha. As I've told you, it will be similar to Rama Shabda. Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, Shayanaha, Shayano, Shayanaha. So, since we are talking about one Shishu, this Shayanaha Shishuhu Swapnam Drishtavan. Can you go to the next Kridanta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, next, as we have discussed, so this pair, Tavatu Uta, we have discussed Tavatu. Now, let us go into Ta Pratyaya. Again, the same thing follows. It's a Bhuta Kridanta. Past perfect. So this is more utilized in past perfect rather than simple past tense. It is used for Karmani Prayoga, as I've told you. And it applies to both Parasmaipadi as well as Atmanepadi Dhatus also. And again, since it forms declinable forms, so this Tavatu Utta, they also are used as adjectives in some cases based on the type of structure. Now, in tavatu, after combining with the dhatu, only vat was left. But in ta pratyaya, only ta will be left. And how it is changing based on linga, I have told here. So for pulinga, the ta will become taha, similar to, then the final word will be similar to Rama Shabda, akaranta pulinga. For strilinga, it will become ta, akaranta strilinga. And for navabhusakalinga, it will remain to be tam, which will become similar to phalam shabda. So it can be used for both parasmaipadi as well as atmanepadi. So these are some of the examples. Save. Sevitaha is pullinga. Sevita, strilinga. Sevitam is napumsakalinga. Ikshdhatu, ikshitaha, ikshita, ikshitam. Varth. This is a little, sometimes as I've told you. So based on how, you know, easily you can understand. Okay, I've made a small mistake here. Varth will be, Varth actually does not have a this thing. So what I mentioned here is the Shanash Pratyaya rule. Please neglect that. That is actually, I forgot to edit that. So, but Varth does not have a Tha Pratyaya. Pat Dhatu has Patitaha, Patita, Patitam. Lik has Likhitaha, Likhita, Likhitam. Drish has Drishtaha, Drishta, Drishtam. Gam, Gataha, Gata, Gatam. Kritaha, Krita, Kritam. Bhutaha, Bhuta, Bhutam. So these are some of the, again, common examples. So I have taken both Atmanepadi as well as Parasmepadi. Save, Iksh are all Atmanepadi. Pat, Lik, Drish, all those are Parasmepadi. So to show that it can act on both Parasmay and Atmanepadi, I have taken this type. Now, let us take some other examples. Now, here, if you see, the sentences have a little bit of past perfect usages here. So the work was done by me. As I've told you, it is mainly used for Karmani Priyoga, Ta Pratyaya. Hence, all the sentences that you will translate will also have Karmani Priyoga, that is passive voice usage. So, the work was done by me. The way to convert it is, again, the literal translation will be Maya Karyam Kritam. So, was done by me. So, as you know, for Karmani Priyoga, the Kartra, the doer should be in Tritiya Vibhakti, the object should be in Prathama Vibhakti, and the Kriyapada should be in Atmanepadi with the Vyakara form. And I think we did not discuss anything with respect to Kriyadhatu in the last class. Hence, the main reason is because, as I've told you, even for, Tavatu Pratyaya, some dhatus act better if you use Lakaras, some dhatus act better if you use Kritantas. This is a particular Kriyadhatu is one which takes up Ta Pratyaya more readily. So, Kritam. So,
sorry, I have a doubt. So, if this were to be converted to Akara form, how will it sound? It will be Maya Karyam Akuryatam, right? Akuryata.
Akuryata. That's what. So, since, Akuryata is the correct. So, it is grammatically correct. But to sound, Maya Karyam Kritam is a better type of usage. That is why some Kridantas are used more often rather than the Lakara form. So, Maya Karyam Akuryata is not actually a very common usage. Even if you write your own answers, it will usually be Maya Karyam Kritam. Of course, once you are acquainted with Kridantas and you come to know that it's a regular usage, you'll use it more often. But what you should understand is Maya Karyam Kritam is a more common and readily used sentence rather than Maya Karyam Akuryata. Okay, so now that is how you have to use. So here in this particular tense, it is a present perfect. So Kritam was done. It is a past perfect tense. Let us take the second example. The dog was beaten by the boy in the playground. Simple sentence. What will be the simple sentence?
The dog was beaten.
Very good. So even you don't need the boy, because we don't need. The dog was beaten itself is a complete sentence. So the dog was beaten. Now how will you convert it into just this particular part? How will we convert? The dog was beaten. Shunakaha. So dog is the object. Dog is not the doer. Who is beating? The boy is beating. The dog is not beating. Hence, the boy is the Kartrupada. The dog is the Karmapada. And beating is the Kriyapada. Hence, according to Karmani Priyoga usage, the dog should be Prathama Vibhakti. So Shunakaha. So Shunakaha. Taditaha. Shunakaha taditaha. Because again, shunaka as well as it is pullinga. Hence, in Karmani Priyoga, the Kriyapada should follow the Karmapada. Karmapada is in pullinga. Hence, taditaha will also be pullinga. So the simple sentence, the dog was beaten will be shunakah taditah. Or if you want to take it in the lakara format, shunakah ataadyata. Ataadyata will be the lakara form. So shunakah taditah. Now we will add the extra details into this. So shunakah kena taditah, by whom was the dog beaten? By
boy.
The boy. So what lakara will, what vibhakti will the boy be in? It will be
Tritiya Vibhakti.
Very good. Since it is Karmani Prayoga, the Kartrupada will be in Tritiya Vibhakti. Hence, the Balaka should be in Tritiya Vibhakti. So Tritiya Vibhakti is Balakena. So Shunakaha Balakena Taditaha will be the dog was beaten by the boy. Now we have added the boy. Now what else is remaining? In the playground. So in the playground, whenever you're talking about a particular location, place, which Vibhakti will use? Saptami Vibhakti.
Saptami Vibhakti.
Very good. So the final detail that you have to add is in the playground. So Kridangana is the playground. Saptami will be Kridangane. So first you took the basic sentence, the dog was beaten. That will translate as Shunakah Taditah. Next, you have added by the Kartrupada, by the boy. So Shunakah Balakena Taditah. The last information you are adding is in the playground. So Shunakah Kridangane Balakena Taditah. Any doubts in the sentence? Okay, now let us look at the third example. The huge Shiva statue at Kedara was seen by me. So what is the bare sentence?
The huge Shiva statue at Kedara was seen.
No, no, no. You don't need huge, you don't need Shiva. All you have to do is the statue at
Kedara. Statue of Kedara was seen.
You don't even need Kedara. The statue was seen by me. That is the basic sentence. Correct? So even by me is also not required. The statue was seen. It, you know, does not matter if it is you or if it is me. Correct? So the bare sentence, like the basic sentence, is the statue was seen. So we will start with that basic sentence and we will build up the information based on that basic sentence. The statue. Statue is Murti. So statue was seen. Who is the doer? Who is seeing?
Me.
Yeah, so the Kartrupada is me. So what will statue become? The Karmapada. Correct? So from that point, so in Karmani Prayoga, the Karmapada should be in Prathama Vibhakti. So Murtihi is Ikaranta Pullinga Shabda. So if you want to just tell the statue was seen, Murtihi, again, Adrishyata is actually, Adrishyata is the Lakara format for Prathama, for Karmani Prayoga using Murti. So Murti, Adrishyata is the statue was seen. Now let us again, Drishtaha. So whatever examples I've discussed here, why I've discussed it is because those are the more commonly used usages rather than the Lakaras. So Krutaha, Krutaha or Krutam, Adrishtaha, all these are more commonly used rather than their Atmanepadi forms in Karmani Prayoga. Hence, Drishtaha is the form because we are talking about Murti. Murti is the object. In Karmani Prayoga, object is of prominence. So Kriyapada should follow the Karmapada. Karmapada here, it's a Pullinga form. Hence, Drishdhatu with Ta Pratyaya, it will become Drishtaha. So the bare sentence, the statue was seen, becomes Murtihi Drishtaha. Now let us add, what, whose Murti, okay, first let us add, who was it seen by? By whom was it seen?
Me.
So what, which lakara, which vibhakti will it, me, be in? It's Karmani Prayoga. So me, that is the doer, will be in Tritiya Vibhakti.
Tritiya Vibhakti.
Very good. So Maya. So Murtihi Maya Drishtaha. Murtihi Maya Drishtaha is the statue was seen by me. Now whose Murti are we talking about?
Shiva statue.
So Shivas, so you are taking apostrophe S, so it will be Shashti Vibhakti. So Shivasya Murtihi Maya Drishta. Now what type of Murti was it? Shivas Murti, but it was a very big Murti. So yeah, huge Murti or a big Murti. So I have added the word, Brihat is actually an Avyaya. So it will just add with Murti. So Shivasya Brihat Murtihi Maya Drishta is Shivas huge statue was seen by me. After adding all this, finally come to the location. Where did you see? in Kedara. And which vibhakti will in Kedara be?
Location.
So it will be Saptami Vibhakti. So any location, whenever you want to describe, it will be in Saptami Vibhakti. So the final translation will be Kedare Shivasya Brihat Murtihi Maya Drishtaha. Okay. Now, see, till now we have seen that Ta Pratyaya is being used as the main verb depicting past participle form. Now let us see how Ta Pratyaya can be used as an adjective. Okay. So now, the shloka told by me is in Ramayana. Now, first identify the main clause and the subclause. Which is the main clause?
Shloka.
Does it make full sense for a sentence to have, like, the main clause is a sentence, part of the sentence, which can make complete sense without additional information. So the shloka, does it make sense? No. You should have at least one verb in the main clause for it to have complete sense. So identify the main clause in the sentence.
Shloka is in Ramayana.
Very good. The shloka is in Ramayana is the main clause, because you have your subject, you have your verb, so that will, and you don't need a subject here. So the object is in this thing. The topic that you're discussing and the verb are in the main clause. That is, the shloka is in Ramayana. The subclause is told by me. So told by me individually does not make sense, because it needs the basic clause. The shloka is in Ramayana to have meaning. So the basic sentence is the shloka is in Ramayana. How can you translate it?
Shlokaha Ramayane Asti.
Excellent. Shlokaha Ramayane Asti. So that is a basic sentence. As you can see, Asti, you have a lakara. Whenever you have adjectives or you have secondary verbs, that is the Kridanta verbs, then your main verb will be in lakara. That I have told you, even in Kshatri Pratyaya as well as Shanish Pratyaya. So here, now we are going to the second subclause. So told by me. So told is what type of a tense? Was told, actually.
Past tense.
Yeah, past tense. But if you actually see the sentence, it is the shloka that was told by me is in Ramayana. So that was told is understood. So I've just made it told by me. So was told is past perfect form. And that is why you have to use the pratyaya. So told by me. How will you just translate that part? Maya uktaha. So again.
Maya uktaha.
So told by me, again, it is a passive type of usage. So maya uktaha shlokaha ramayane asti. So maya uktaha is where you are using the ta pratyaya. And here uktaha is a type of adjective. So what type of a shloka is in Ramayana? The shloka that is told by me. So told by me is an adjective to the shloka, correct?
Yes, Anna.
So what you have in the sentence, what I wanted to tell you is, in the sentence, the main the verb that you have is in lakara format, and ta pratyaya verb has come as an adjective. So the shloka is in Ramayana. So as I've told you, even in the previous slides, in the previous kridantas, the main verb is told is highlighted in red, and the secondary verb is highlighted in green. So is asti is your main verb, told is the adjective and the secondary verb. And you should again find out the tense. If it is present continuous tense, it will either be Kshatriya or Shanish Pratyaya. If it is past tense, it can either be Tavatu Pratyaya or Ta Pratyaya. But again, Tavatu Pratyaya is only simple past. And you cannot have simple past in your adjective form. You can never use a simple past tense in your secondary clause. It should always be past perfect form. So that is why if it is past, always use Ta Pratyaya. But if it is present continuous, you can either use Kshatri or Shanash depending on the type of dhatu. If it's Atmanepadi, you should use Shanash Pratyaya. If it is Parasmepadi, you should use Kshatri Pratyaya. So this sentence was to give you this idea of secondary clause and primary clause. Next, again, we'll continue the same type of usage in the next few examples. Forgive the mistake done by me. What is the basic sentence?
Forgive the mistake.
Excellent. So, forgive the mistake is your basic sentence. Hence, forgive is your main verb. Done by me is your secondary clause, and done is your secondary verb. So, first we'll just translate the primary, that is the main clause. Forgive the mistake. So, how will you translate this? Kshamatu kshamatat kshamatam kshamantu. Kshamasva kshamatat kshamatam kshamata. Kshamani kshamava kshamama. So, kshamdhatu you have to, since you're asking forgiveness, so whenever you ask for forgiveness or you ask for a request or you ask for orders, you always use lot lakara. Hence, kshamasva is lot lakara. Madhyam, since you is understood, so I have put it in the bracket. So you forgive the mistake. So since tvam is madhyama purusha usage, so your lot lakara madhyama purusha ekavachana should be used. Which is kshamasva. So forgive the mistake.
Kritam kshamasva.
No. Kritam will be done by me. So you have to not bring in kritam. So first is forgive the mistake. Just that part will be tvam aparadham kshamasva. You forgive the mistake. What type of a mistake is it? The mistake that was done by me. Yeah, so done by me. Hence, you should use the pratyaya and it should be in karmani prayoga. So, maya kritam aparadham kshamasva. And again, if you see, whenever you have to use such adjectives, you can't bring in lakara. So, in the first few, in the first three examples, there is a chance that you can, if you don't know the kritanta form, you can always use lakara form. But in the next few examples where the ta pratyaya is being used as an adjective, that is a past participle verb is acting as an adjective, you can never use lakara. Lakara is only for verbs, it is not for adjectives. Hence, kritanta's past participle and past perfect and simple past are used for that particular usages when you have such adjectives coming in. So I think, the reason that probably kritantas can be used is for that. If you want to use a past participle adjective, then you have to use kritantas. You can't use lakaras. Okay, any doubts until here?
No, no.
Okay, now people live happily in the city protected by the king. So what is the simple sentence?
People live in the city.
People live. People live is the simple sentence. In the city is additional, happily is additional. If people live, it's understood. It's complete sentence. If they live in the
people
city.
People are happy in the.
No. Just people live is a sentence because people can live happily in the city or in the village or in the kingdom or in the palace, whatever. People can live happily or sadly, whatever. So, but people live. That should be your main part. Without that, you cannot add any other adjectives or locations. So, people live is your main sentence. So, how will you translate it into Sanskrit?
Janaha vasanti.
Very good. Vasdhatu, vasati, vasataha, vasanti. So since janaha is pullinga, janaha is pullinga bahuvachanam, you should use bahuvachanam even in your vasdhatu, vasati, vasataha, vasanti. So janaha, vasanti. Now we will add extra details. People live happily. So whenever, whenever you're using such adjectives like happily, sadly, you should use tritiya vibhakti. Hence, janaha sukhena vasanti. The people live with happiness. So the literal way to translate it in English is people live with happiness. Hence, sukhena with tritiya vibhakti. So janaha sukhena jivanti. Now we'll translate. People live happily in the city. How will you translate that?
Nagare janaha sukhena vasanti.
Very good. So you're adding satami vibhakti form for nagara to show the location. So nagare janaha sukhena vasanti. So this will be your main clause. So your basic sentence is people live, but in this particular example given, their main clause will be people live happily in the city. Your sub clause is protected by the king. So what type of a city are they living in? They're living in a city that is protected by the king. So whatever is the adjective that you're adding is for the nagara, that is a city. So your the protected, that is the ta pratyaya usage, will follow the nagara word. So nagara is nagaram. It is a napumsakalinga form. So nagaram, nagare, nagarani. So it should be a napumsakalinga form. It should be in saptami vibhakti and it should be ekavachanam. So rakshitam is the, so rakshitaha, rakshita, rakshitam is the pullinga, strilinga, napumsakalinga form. So rakshitam is similar to phalam. Saptami will be rakshite. So rakshite nagare, the protected, the people are living in a protected city. So rakshite nagare sukhena jivanti janaha. What, who is protecting? By the king. So ragnya rakshite nagare janaha sukhena vasanti.
What form is rakshite?
Rakshite is rakshitam, that is the napumsakalinga form. Saptami vibhakti ekavachanam, similar to phale. Because rakshita, the word should follow nagara. Nagare is in saptam, is similar to phale. Hence, rakshit, raksh dhatu with the tavat ta pratyaya should also be similar to phale. that's only possible in the Napumsakalinga form, Saptami Bhakti Ekavachanam, Rakshitam Rakshit, Phalam Phale Phane, Rakshitam Rakshite Rakshitani, Saptami will be Rakshite.
But the people are the ones who are protected, right? So Rakshite, Rakshita should follow Janaha, right?
What are we describing here? Rule that you are mentioning is if you are using it as a verb and if it is Karmani Prayoga. But here we are using it as an adjective. So the first three examples was based on Ta Pratyaya being used as a verb. In that point of time, you should always follow Karmani Prayoga rule and the verb should follow the Karma Pada. But here, you are not using the Ta Pratyaya as your main verb. So Vasati is your main verb and that is following the Kartari Prayoga because people live happily. That is your active voice usage. Hence, active voice is valid there. But now, Ta Pratyaya is being used as an adjective. What is the adjective describing? So what are you describing in the protected by the king? You're describing the city. Hence, the Ta Pratyaya should go along with the city rather than the people.
I think we can also interpret it as the people are protected, right? So I think you are interpreting as the city is being protected.
You are taking it that the people were protected by the king. Okay. That's what you are considering, right?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, so of course, I think I've made it clear because I've put a comma. So usually if you put a comma after a noun,
right. The
next couple of phrases will be for the particular sentence, for the particular word.
Correct.
So yeah, let us change the sentence. It will be an exercise for you as well. So now let us make the people protected by the king live happily in the city. So now we'll bring the protected by the king to describe the people rather than the city. I'll translate that and we'll come to know how that changes. So the new sentence that we'll be discussing is the people who are protected by the king live happily in the city. So their basic sentence is still people live happily in the city. So Janaha, Nagare, Sukhena, Vasanti is your still basic sentence. But now protected by the king is no longer describing the city. It is describing the people. So Ragnya will remain the same because protected by the king. So you're talking about passive voice. So the doer, that is the king who is protecting, will be in Tritiya Vibhakti. So Ragnya. Now Raksh will now have the form similar to Janaha. So Janaha is Pullinga, Prathama Vibhakti, Bahuvachanam. Hence, Ragnya, Rakshitaha, Janaha, Nagare Sukhena Vasanti.
Yeah, right. Correct.
Yeah. So that is how the same sentence can, based on how you put the comma and how you describe which part you're describing, the Ta Pratyaya will also change. So that is how it is changed. So I hope both the examples are clear and you can get a better understanding. Okay. The final example for this is, what is the name of the girl who went? What is your main sentence here?
What is the name?
Very good. What is the name? So what is the translation in Sanskrit?
Namakim.
Very good. So Namakim Asti is your complete sentence, but usually you omit Asti because it's understood. So Namakim. Tava Namakim is correct. That is Bhavataha Namakim is correct. But you can add Asti, that's why I have put it in bracket because Asti is not commonly used. It is just omitted from the sentence. So Namakim is what is the name. Now let us add the sentence. Whose name are we talking about?
Balikaya.
So the girl's name. We are talking about the girl's name. It is Shashti Vibhakti. So Balikayaha Nama Kim. Now, what type of girl?
Who went?
So who went? So we are talking about a girl who is going. So went is again past perfect tense. So you should always use Ta Pratyaya in this case. Gamdhatu. Went. You have to use Gamdhatu. It should have Ta Pratyaya. And what should be the Linga Vibhakti Vachana of that Gamdhatu usage? What should it be similar to in this word, in this sentence? Whom are you describing in this sentence?
It should follow Balika.
Very good. So, who went, that particular phrase is describing the girl. So, that phrase should always...
Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachana.
Is it Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachana? Balikayaha. So
Tritiya Vibhakti Bahuvachana.
No.
Shashti.
Very good. Shashti Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Balikayaha Shashti Vibhakti Sitayaha Sitayoho Sitayam Shashti Vibhakti Ekavachanam. So here, who went, that Gamdhatu's त प्रत्यय वर्ड शुड ऑल्सो बी स्त्रीलिंग षष्ठी विभक्ति एकवचनम सो गता गते गता गतां गते गता गतया गताभ्यां गताभि इफ यू कम टू द सिक्स्थ षष्ठी विभक्ति गतायाः सो गतायाः बालिकायाः नाम किम् ओके सो अगेन दिस प्रैक्टिस अ लॉट मोर ऑफ दी सेंटेंसेस टू गेट अ हैंग ऑफ व्हेन द बिकम्स योर मेन वर्ब व्हेन इट बिकम्स एन एडजेक्टिव इफ इट्स अ मेन वर्ब यू शुड यूज द रूल्स ऑफ कर्तरी एंड कर्मणि प्रयोग दैट वी डिस्कस्ड If it's an adjective, then it should follow the word that it is describing. If it is who went is describing the girl. So whatever you're adding that ta pratyaya usage, it should follow the linga vibhakti vachana of the girl. If you're talking about the city protected by the king, that phrase should follow the city, its linga vibhakti vachana. If it is shloka, told by me, so you're describing the shloka, so the told by me should follow the shloka. Okay. So we will just do one more pair of pratyayas today and we will end today's class. So I will complete these two and tomorrow's regular class we'll finish Kridanta's topic and we will look into some new topics. So the last two Kridantas for today is Tavyat and Aniyar Pratyaya. This is for Vidhyartha. So again, you have order. So Vidhiling Lakara is already there for you for if you want to discuss about Lakaras that give you order. So for example, pathet, likhet, all those vidhiling lakara usages are also used for order. But tavyat and aniyar are more, you come across them in a more general format. Again, they are beautiful in the way they present. So though you have lakaras, these kridantas add more beauty and they add more impact on the sentence. So vidhyarthaka is the name given to these pratyayas, that is for order or enforcement. They only take up adjective forms. They are based on the object or the bhava. So it can be used for karmani, which is concentrating on object, or for bhave, which is based on the bhava of the verb. Again, they have different linga, vibhakti, vachana usages. Again, alternative to vidhiring lakara, but more assertive. So they give you more impact in your sentences. First, let us look into tavyat. Tavyat, the first three are common, but again, tavyat can be used for both parasmepadi as well as atmanepadi dhatus. In the tavyat, once you add it to the dhatu, only tavya will remain. And the tavya for pullinga will become tavyaha, similar to ramaha. Strilinga tavya, similar to sita or rama. Navamsakalinga will become tavyam, similar to phalam. Some examples. Sevitavyaha, sevitavya, sevitavyam. Ikshitavyaha, ikshitavya, ikshitavyam. Vartitavyaha, vartitavya, vartitavyam. Patitavyaha, patitavya, patitavyam. Likhitavya, likhitavya, likhitavyam, and these are the common usages that are more used in tavyat pratyaya usage rather than vidhiring. So, for example, patdhatu, pathet, patetam, patayuhu can be used, but patitavya is a more assertive. So, pathet. So, the translation like a suitable translation in English will be let the lesson, for example, patha pathet will mean let the lesson be read, but patitavya is telling you. The lesson should be read. So you're adding more assertiveness into your particular sentence. So that is the main usage for tavyat. Examples. Dharma has to or must or should be protected by us. So again, as I've told you, tavyat is always used for karmani prayoga usage. Tavyat and aniya, these pairs are always used for bhave or karmani prayoga. Hence, you should always know that you should always follow the rules of karmani prayoga in these types of pratyayas. So dharma is again pullinga dharma rakshitavyah. So I'll since you have there's no alternative, you can again if you want to let us say use the lakara usage. So dharma rakshet will be the word dharma asmabhi by us. So you are telling by us. So it will be karmani prayoga. So the doer who's protecting, we are protecting. So we should be in tritiya vibhakti. So aham avam vayam mama avam nam asmana maya asmakam maya avabhyam asmabhi. So asmabhi dharma rakshet, because dharma is only ekavachanam, so rakshet, it will not follow the kartrapada, it will follow the karmapada. Now let us use the tavyat pratyaya. So
it will be rakshayet, right?
Rakshayet, no, rakshet is the correct usage, because it's a parasmepadi. Oh yeah, excellent, sir. Yeah, you're using karmani priya. Yeah, rakshayet, correct. Correct, yes, rakshayet. Rakshayeta, sorry, rakshayetam will be the atmanepadi then. Sorry, rakshet is your prasmaipadi form, patet patetam pateyuh. In Atmanepadi it will become rakshyatam. Labhatam, labhetam, labhantam is a vidhiling in this thing. Correct?
Vidhiling is pateta, patetam, pateran. So, rakshayeta.
In Atmanepadi, I think, okay. Rakshatam, rakshetam, sorry. Labhatam, labhetam, labhantam is vishlakara.
Labhatam, labhetam, labhantam is...
Lotlakara. Correct?
No, there is labhyatam, labhyatam, labhyantam will be lot Atmanepadi.
No. Labhyatam, if you are using it as particularly in Karmani Prayoga, but if you want to use it in Kartari Prayoga, you won't have the yakara there.
Labhatu, labhatat, labhatam, labhanti.
No. Labh is an Atmanepadi. So it will be labhate, labhete, labhanti is a latlakara. So labhatam, labhetam, labhantam is your lotlakara. Yeah, correct. So here, if you wanted to use lakara form, then it will be rakshyatam. Rakshyatam, it will be your lotlakara, vidhiring lakara. Sorry, vidhiring lakara will be rakshyatam. But here we are using the tavyat pratyaya, so you are adding more assertiveness. So instead of telling, let dharma be protected. So again, if you use that vidhiring lakara, the translation will be, let dharma be protected by us. But here you are telling, dharma should be protected by us. So dharma asmabhi rakshitavyah, it should be protected. Again, since you are using karmani prayoga, the kriyapada, the verb will follow the dharma. Hence it is pullinga prathama eka. Now, next. What is right must be done. So we are telling that something, if something is correct, that has to be done. So instead of using vidhiring lakara, since you are asserting must be done, it is better to use tavyat pratyaya. So yati yuktam, what is right, yati yuktam tat kartavyam. Kartavyam is because you are using yat. So yat is napumsakalinga pada. So yati yuktam tat kartavyam. Kartavya is the pullinga form, kartavyam is the napumsakalinga form, because you are using tat or yat tat, that you are using those two pairs which are napumsakalinga usages. Next, man must see the Manasarovara at least once in his life. You're not just saying, let someone see Manasarovara. You're telling, man must see. So you are asserting, so you should use tavyat pratyaya. So man must see the Manasarovara. Manavena, because you're using Atmani, sorry, you're using Karmani Prayoga, the Kartra should be in Tritya. So manavena, jivane, in his life, ekada, at least once, Manasarovaraha, Trashtavya. Sarovaraha is your pullinga form. Sarovara is pullinga, similar to Ramaha. Hence, whatever you are using for must see, that is a tavyat pratyaya, should also be in the same linga vibhakti vachana as that, sarovara. So, sarovara is pullinga prathama eka. Hence, drashtavya is also pullinga prathama eka. So, if you want to use it as lakara format, so manavena jivane ekada manasa sarovara jivane manasa sarovara drishyatam. Okay, any doubts with the lakara as well as tavyat pratyaya?
Drishyatam become lot again, right? Sorry for...
Yeah, that's what. Drishyeta is your lot, vidhiling lakara, is it?
Right.
Yeah, sorry. I was actually confused between lot and vidhiling in Atmani and Parasnikari. Sorry, yeah. So it will be rakshyeta, sorry, drishyeta. No, is it clarified? I was sorry about mistake. So drishyeta.
Okay. Can you once again repeat it, please?
Okay, so in the tavyat... In the tavyat pratyaya usage, that is, must be seen, manavena jivane ekada manas sarovara drashtavyaha, that is, must be seen. Now, if you want to use it, let it be seen, that is, if you are using vidhiling lakara, the entire sentence remains to be the same. Manavena jivane ekada manas sarovara, this part continues to be the same, just the verb will change to vidhiling lakara, that is, drishyeta. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Now let us till now what we saw was we are using tavyat pratyaya kridantas as your main verb. Now let us try to use this tavyat pratyaya words as your adjectives. Now, among the scriptures that must be read, Gita is important. So what is your main? So again, we are, you know, whenever you have these adjectives, you always have to try to segregate the main clause from your subclause. So what is your main clause?
Gita is important.
Yeah, very good.
Gita is important.
Gita is important is your main clause because it has your topic that you're discussing. It has your verb is, which is your main verb. So that is your main clause. Gita is important. So how will you translate it into Sanskrit? Gita pramukha asti. So again, asti can be let go of, but we'll kind of, I've mentioned it for you to understand the completeness of the sentence. So Gita pramukha asti. Now what type of, why are you discussing Gita? You're telling that among the scriptures that has to be read, Gita is important. So you have to concentrate on, so must be read is telling you about the scriptures. So what must be read? Scriptures must be read. So it must be read is describing your scriptures. So scriptures have used the word grantha. Among grantha. So how, I know which vibhakti will you use for among?
Saptami vibhakti.
Very good. So among scriptures, grantheshu, because you're using bahuvachana, multiple scriptures. So grantheshu, grantheshu, Gita pramukha. Among scriptures, Gita is important. That is your second basic sentence. But what type of scriptures? The scriptures that must be read. So you have to use tavyat pratyaya and it should follow what? It should follow the scriptures because what should be read? The scriptures should be read. Hence, whatever is the linga vibhakti vachana of the scriptures, the same thing will be taken up by must be read tavyat pratyaya usage. So patitavyaha is the pullinga form. And if you want to use grantheshu, grantheshu is saptami vibhakti bahuvachanam. So patitavyeshu grantheshu Gita pramukha asti. Again, here you can't use vidhiling lakara because again, as I've told you repeatedly, lakaras can only be used if your word is coming as a verb. It cannot be used if the same verb is coming as your adjective. For example, crying girl. If you want to tell, if you want to use crying, you can never use any type of lakara. You can only use pratyaya, that is shatru pratyaya. Here also, must be read. You can never use past tense or vidhiling lakara as you have used in the previous examples. You have to use, I know for adjectives, you have to use Kriganta itself. Any doubts? Fourth example. Okay. Now, we will look into the final example. The poor must never be laughed about by us. So, the simple sentence is, we should not laugh at the poor. But now we are using the passive voice. So, we should not laugh at the poor. The poor should not be laughed by us. Laughed at by us. So, the translation will be nirdhana. Now, I've used the word nirdhana, nirdhanaha for poor. So, nirdhanana vishay. So, I've used about the poor. So, vishaye. So, nirdhanana. We should not laugh about the poor people's topic is the literal translation. So, nirdhanana vishaye asmabhi naiva hasitavyam. Why I've used this for last sentences to show bhavya prayoga usage. Has dhatu, as you know, is an akarmaka dhatu. It does not take any object, so it is a bhavya prayoga usage. But still, you can use tavyat pratyaya to show that you can use tavyat pratyaya not only for karmani prayoga, but also for bhavya prayoga. I have used this last sentence, wherein I have used has dhatu in a tavyat pratyaya usage. And again, the same rule applies. What was the rule for bhavya prayoga's kriyapada? It should always be atmanepadi, prathama purusha, ekavachanam in that particular lakara. Here also, whatever be the, since you don't have any object, whatever be the sentence, it should always be in napumsakalinga, whatever the dhatu, napumsakalinga of that particular kriyapada, tavyat pratyaya, prathama purusha, ekavachanam only. Hasitavyam is napumsakalinga, prathama purusha, ekavachanam only. So you should use only that when you're using that particular word as your main verb. So here, to be laughed is the only verb and it's your main verb. That will always be in napumsakalinga, prathama vibhakti, ekavachanam. To show the bhavya prayoga usage in tavyat, I've used the last sentence. Any doubts in the last sentence?
No doubt.
Okay. So we will end today's lesson with this last pratyaya. So that is aniyar pratyaya. So the same thing applies to both. So both of them are for order or enforcement. They are both used for karmani and bhavya, and they apply both to parasmaya and atmayapadi dhatus. So now, similar to how you know the different pratyayas add, whenever you add aniyar pratyaya, just the aniya will be included in your dhatu. And for pullinga, it will become aniyaha, similar to ramaha, aniya, similar to rama, aniyam, similar to phalam for pullinga, strilinga, and navumsakalinga forms. Some common examples that I have taken up is sev, sevaniya, sevaniya, sevaniyam, pathaniya, pathaniya, pathaniyam, lekhaniya, lekhaniya, lekhaniyam, and similarly for the remaining dhatus. Again, this again, you can't, vidhiling has a different usage. Vidhiling will tell you, let them be. So save, if you use save dhatu, seveta, seveyatam, severan, if you use the vidhiling lakara, it is telling you, let them be served or let them be helped. But if you use sevaniyaha, it is, they have to be, respected, or they have to be served. So that is the assertiveness that you're adding for the tavyat and aniyar pratyaya. Okay? Now, we will look into some examples for aniyar pratyaya. Again, I'm use the same example for the that I had taken in, not all the examples, but at least some of the examples that I have taken there, I've used again here to show that you can use tavyat and aniyar pratyaya interchangeably. So there, the sentence was, has to be, so rakshdhatu, you can use as if, so that is the flexibility of tavyat and aniyar. Both of them have usages both in parasmaipadi as well as atmanepadi. So unlike Kshatriya and Shanash, wherein you have to decide if the first you should know what is a dhatu, if it is atmanepadi or parasmaipadi, and then decide which pratyaya to use, tavyat and aniyar gives you the flexibility that you can use anything for anyone. Because there we use rakshdhatu itself, but with tavyat pratyaya to get rakshitavyaha. Here I have used the same rakshdhatu, but as with aniyar pratyaya to use rakshaniyaha. So if you rakshdhatu, I have not mentioned it in this list, but rakshdhatu, rakshaniyaha, rakshaniya, rakshaniyam. So what are you protecting? That object is dharma, which is pullinga. Hence it is rakshaniyaha. Asmabhi dharma rakshaniyaha. Asmabhi dharma rakshitavyaha. Tavyat aniyar for the same word, for the same sentence, both being valid and exactly same sentences. There is no change. Again, in the previous, tavyat we had used, what is read must be done. There it was, yat yuktam tat kartavyam. Here I have used, yat yuktam tat karaniyam. There also it was napumsakalinga, here also it's napumsakalinga, because yat tat, that pair is used only for napumsakalinga. Hence, karaniyam also takes up napumsakalinga form. These two were using tavyat taniyar kritantas as your main verbs. Now let us see how to use them as your adjectives. The next sentence is, among the places that must be seen, Kashi is sacred. So in this sentence, Kashi is sacred is your main sentence. So that is your basic sentence. Kashi is sacred. So Kashi kshetram pavitram. Vartate asti, again, it is extra. You can remove that or you can keep that. That is, based on how you use it, both are valid. Kashi kshetram pavitram is also correct. Kashi kshetram pavitram asti or vartate is also correct. So that is your basic sentence. Now, why are you discussing about Kashi? You are discussing about some place, among the places. Again, among, when you are using Saptami Vibhakti. So, kshetreshu, among the places, kshetreshu. What type of places that must be seen? So, must be seen is describing what in the sentence?
Kashi Kshetram.
No. Must be seen is describing the places. So, among the places that must be seen. So, that must be seen is describing the places. So Kashi is sacred.
Darshaniya.
Darshan. Yeah. So must be seen. Whatever is the word that you'll use for the must be seen, it should follow the linga, vibhakti, vachana of the places. So kshetreshu is kshetra, pullinga, saptami vibhakti, bahuvachanam form. Hence, whatever must be seen, that word you use also should have pullinga, saptami vibhakti, ekavachanam. Darshaniya, darshaniya, darshaniyam. So darshaniya, pullinga, Saptami Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. Ramasya Ramayoho Ramanam, Rame Ramayoho Rameshu, Darshaniyeshu, Kshetreshu, Kashi Kshetram, Pavitram Vartate. So, the Darshaniya, that word, is following the Linga Vibhakti Vachana of Kshetra. Kshetreshu is Pullinga Saptami Bahu. His Darshaniya should also have Pullinga Saptami Bahu form, that is Darshaniyeshu. Similarly, in the next sentence, among the people who must be served, mother is of prominence. So, mother is of prominence is your basic sentence. Mata pramukha asti. Mother is of prominence. So, that is your basic sentence. Why are you discussing about mother? You are telling about some people. So, janeshu. Some people. Among people, janeshu. What type of people the people who must be served. Hence again, who must be served, that is describing the people. So jana, whatever the linga vibhakti vachana you have, must be served also should follow that. So must be served, as I have discussed, sev dhatu, sevaniya, sevaniya, sevaniyam. But jana is a pullinga, similar to ramaha. So it will take among people will become janeshu, saptami vibhakti bahuvachanam. Hence sevaniya also will become pullinga saptami bahu sevaniyeshu. Sevaniyeshu janeshu mata pramukha asti. So in the first two sentences, your aniyar was used as your main verb, whereas in this next two sentences, aniyar was used as your adjective, and that adjective should follow the linga vibhakti vachana of your noun that you are describing. Okay. Any doubts in the four pratyayas that we discussed today? Okay. So tomorrow again we'll have the regular class. I'll tell you the exact timings by today evening based on the other classes that you will have. Tomorrow by finishing Kridantas, I'll be finishing the complete combined grammar that you have. Next, whatever grammar you have, it will be done individually because there is no correlation. Since these topics that we have discussed, that is Kridantas, the Prayoga Parivartanam are common to both Tritiya as well as Turiya, hence we have this combined class. So after this, we will start with our individual topics again and we'll continue. So tomorrow we will end the combined class topic of Kridantas. So with that, if you don't have any other doubts, we'll end today's class. Any doubts, please ask and we can clarify.
No doubt.
Okay. So we will end today's class. Tomorrow we will meet at the prescribed time. Guru reva gatihi guru meva bhaje guru naiva sahasmi namo gurave na guroh paramam shishurasmi guror matirasti gurau mama pahi guru. Ram, Ram, Ram.